Hello everybody, this is the Duke Minecraft, and welcome to Tango Tech's Patreon server. So I'm actually going to do a series on this server. I'm going to do a bunch of building for this first episode, but a lot of it's going to be off camera because it's going to take a lot of work. So yeah, we're on the Patreon server here. This is near the spawn chunks. We've got the Iron Titan over there. You can kind of see it from here. So I picked this area for my base because it's really close to the spawn. And I wanted to pick a spot where it's not going to block anybody's view. So my base is actually going to be way up in the air. Just going to be a gear up there. I'm trying to do it with my mouse. You can't really see it. But it'll be pretty big up there. But it shouldn't block the view to anything. I hope it'll look pretty cool. But yeah, so I've already gotten a little bit of a start on the server here, and Drop the Base was so kind of me. On my first night here on the server, he stopped by and gave me a skeleton horse, and he also gave me a bunch of iron and some food. And yeah, so let me just show some footage from the first night or day or whatever. Well, I spawned in right here. Oh, there's Tango. He's giving me a punch in the back. Oh, you can whisper? How do you do that? I know Tango's a busy man, so I don't want to waste his time giving me a tour. We got so many other people on. I don't know if anyone else would want to give me a tour, but, okay, how about I just kind of wander around? That's my strategy right now. I'm just gonna... But there's creepers out. Oh, I don't want to break anyone's things. I don't want to take anything yet. I don't feel comfortable just punching the trees around here, because I feel like I'll be wrecking the scenery. Ooh. Oh man, okay. So this guy just gave me a bunch of stuff. He gave me a horse, some chicken, and some iron to start out on the server. Drop the Base. Thank you very much, kind sir. Oh, Glammy might give me... Yeah. Alright, Glammy might be giving me a tour here. Okay. Oops.
Okay. Tour. Where do you want to start?
I'm not sure. Maybe just all the stuff in town first.
Well, this is just a spawn town. There's like no shops in here or anything.
Oh.
This is where people are building their bases.
Is there another town?
It's kind of divided into districts. So there's like a shopping district, there's an entertainment district, there's a couple residential districts, but then people are also out on their own. Yeah. So this is the shopping district right here.
Oh, okay. Maybe I'll just leave the horse right here.
I would take it with you.
Okay.
If I would have known you had a horse, I would have brought to mine.
I didn't know I was going to get a horse, and this guy's like, hey, you want a horse? I was like, sure. And then he brought me a horse and food. That was really nice of him.
Yeah, it was really nice.
Oh, fossils?
Yeah, fossil craft. This is a pretty... Here, they sell... They're selling, like, netherbrick and enchanted books. Let's see. Name tags.
Is there anywhere where I could just get, like, double chests of stone that nobody wants?
I doubt it this early on. Anyway, nice meeting you. I'm gonna take off for a while. I'll talk to you guys later.
Cat.
Bye, Cat.
Hop in the boat.
So the Titan is only for Titan Guild members?
No, the Titan Guild members are the caretakers of the Titan.
Okay.
So there's a shop in the shopping center where we will take all of the iron and dump it in there. So that people aren't breaking into the redstone underneath the Titan, which has been a very major issue.
Oh, wow.
So...
Oh, is this it right here?
This is my little area. Yeah.
Cool.
So, like I said, you got hills all around you, and then this island right here.
It'd actually be kind of cool to set it up above the water.
Okay, you're welcome to do so. Also, over here, in case you want to use it.
Is there a spawner?
Yes. I got a skeleton spawner automatic. Oh. Just got AFK here.
So cool.
That's found it by accident too.
That's definitely the best spawner. Oop. Oh, sorry.
Keep mine hitboxes.
Yeah, I haven't played with like any versions with the hitboxes yet.
Yeah, I was pushed off of one of the Titans a couple of times.
So yeah, Drop the Base and Glammy have been really kind to me so far, and we're kind of like. Just chatting in Discord right now, actually. So yeah, we're hanging out and doing stuff and things on the server. It's been a lot of fun so far, actually. And Drop the Base also said he might not mind giving me like a bunch of stone and stuff to get started on the gear here. So I might have to take him up on the offer and see if he wants to give me a bunch of things for the gear. His base is actually really close by, and that's why I decided on putting it here. Because his base... is just around this peninsula here, maybe? I think it's somewhere around here. Over here. Pretty sure. So my base will be pretty close to his. I'll be able to fly over to it, and he's actually got a skeleton spawner. So he said he wouldn't mind if we used it too. So I'm just gonna try to find his base here real quick. We got a lava pool there. And I think, yeah, that's his barn. He has some horses in there. And, yeah, there's the skeleton spawner. I can't remember where, but it's somewhere down there, underground somewhere. But, yeah, this is his base. Casa, they dropped the base. And so, yeah, he said he might not mind giving me a bit of stone and stuff. And so, yeah, he's been really kind to me on the server so far, same with Glammy. So I might be doing some collabs with them in the future. But yeah, I'm going to get to work on a bit more of the gear. Oop. And I'll join you guys in a bit. Thank you. So yeah, we are back now. And I can't believe I actually did it. In the span of 2 days, I've completed this giant gear. All survival. And I just took out the ladders here. I don't know why I did that. But let's bust in. So there is some block lag on the server. Oh, someone left a sign. Well, it is in my YouTuber tag. Slightly insane. Just a bit. So yeah. I did the gear. Took me about 12 hours of work over the past 2 days. I've been going ham on it. I wanted to get it built as soon as possible. Just to kind of push myself and see if I could do it. So yeah, all the blocks I laid out, and I couldn't have done it without the help of a lot of people. So if you see this video, thank you so much to Salt Feather, who donated some andesite. I asked a lot of people, like, I would just say, hey, anyone got any stone? And it was surprising, so many people were actually, yeah, actually I got a few stacks you can have. And so I got so many donations. I got a lot from Drop the Base. Some other people gave me some. I don't know if I recognize any that are on right now. Maybe. I feel bad because I don't remember all the people who gave me stuff. But I had other people run up and throw stone at me and andesite at me. So it was awesome. I didn't have to do like really any resource collecting to complete this gear. So yeah, you can run around in the inside of it. But it's mainly for decoration. Because the primary focus of the build here is going to be on what's in the middle of the gear. So next episode we'll probably start on that. I've already put tons and tons of time into getting this one going. So we got this giant gear laid out, and we'll take some more looks at it from below and stuff. But yeah, what I want to put in the middle, I think it's going to be pretty sweet. We're going to put like a series of floating islands, like a big one in the middle and maybe some other ones sprinkled about, dotted around, maybe some beneath the gear. And eventually I might put other gears up in the sky, none quite as big as this one because this is going to be marking the center of the base. So yeah, it turned out really good. I still have some areas to light up like here. So I need to light up on the edges of the gear here. I want to do it in an orderly pattern like this. I have the torches every third block pretty much, so it looks not too bad. But yeah, let's jump off and take a look at it from below. Oh, yeah, that's a little bit of the rubber banding lag. I've died a few times to that because I jumped down and would like try to catch myself on the ladder, then it would rubber band me back out away from the ladder and I'd like land here. I'm like, no. So yeah, I'll have to remove all this platform and stuff. And this is like everything I own, by the way, besides like stone and stuff up there. So I pretty much got on the server and started building the gear after I toured around and looked at some other things. But yeah. Oh man, it's looking sweet up there. It's going to look even better once we take out the pillar. Right, so, also, I've got an amazing view of the two awesome golem statues here. It's really quite cool, and the Titan's right nearby. So yeah, I'm not really too sure what else to do this episode. Maybe we'll take a look around the server, actually. So I kind of want to see if this is far enough away from other people's portals to be able to set up a portal. If it is, that would be really nice to be able to get a portal up there. I'm not sure if it will be too close to this portal, though. But right here is the closest portal to me, I believe. Let's see. This would be T-Bog's place. So yeah, there's a bit of stuff going on in the nether right now. There's like two nether hubs. There's an original nether hub, and then there is a lower nether hub that's going to be the new one or something. So yeah, here's the old nether hub. Looks like people are removing pieces of it, or I don't know. It's getting changed. Here's some. Do not enter. New Netherhood not ready. Ah, I really want to take a peek. Okay, we'll just go in real quick. They got a ghast in here. That's what I wanted to show off. They got a ghast here. Oh, who? What's his name? Here lies Big Richard. Nifty. So yeah, here's gonna be like the new portal to Titan. So this might be the new closest one. I'll have to see if I'll be able to hook up a portal. I'll ask some of like the moderators because I don't want to screw up with anyone's portal. But yeah, so there's a shopping district, which eventually I want to set up a shop here. And I have a cool idea for one. It's nothing gonna be too crazy, but I'm gonna sell piston doors or secret redstone doors. So yeah, there's tons of shops around here already. Big sign for shops. There's ice you can get. Free packed ice, take what you need, daily restock. Free fish for the hungry. Oh, cool. I don't have any food, so that's really nice. There's a lottery, there's looks like bone blocks, packed ice, tons of stuff everywhere. So let me show you the location I picked out. Over here, there's this big piston with a like lantern, and I picked out an area near it because it looked like I looked around, there wasn't anyone nearby, so I think it's clear. And I marked out the area with netherrack so people kind of see. Glammy helped me do that. Future site of Duke's Piston Door Shop. So we'll be in this area. Also, another thing, there's so many skeleton horses all around the server. It's crazy. Yeah. But yeah, so many cool builds around the server. It's fun to take a look around and just see what all there is. but I think most of my focus is going to be on trying to make my base pretty developed in the first episodes here. I might start the shop sometime around the third or fourth or fifth episode. Not too sure. But yeah, lots of cool things. I don't have like any diamonds or anything yet, so I'm not going to be able to buy anything yet. Oh man, this person's shop is ridiculous. Exquisite enchantments, the finest enchantments around. Mending books, 5 diamonds each. Pay and chest over here. Oh, it's got hoppers behind underneath it. That's very neat. Oh, I should, oh, they got new noises, that's right. What I need to do is get the stone out of here. Someone let me have a ton of stone, so I just loaded up my ender chest. And I didn't actually need to use it yet. But I will need a crap load of stone for the floating island. But yeah, so there's lots of things to look at around here, but let's head back to the base area. There's so many people on all the time. There's always like at least 40 people on here. It's crazy. I haven't seen it drop beneath 40. And it's normally like 40 to 50 people. So yeah, where did I come out of? Portal. Here. T-Bog. So maybe I'll ask some moderators or someone who knows the Nether Hub well and see if I might be able to hook up another portal to this gear. Because this portal is fairly close. And obviously the Titan needs a portal, but I think the Titan's a little further away than this one is. So I think it could be possible. I'm hoping it is, because that would be nice to be able to go into a portal and pop up all the way up in the top of the gear instead of having to slowly take a ladder up, which is painfully slow. But yeah, that's probably going to wrap it up for this first episode. So I appreciate everybody for watching. Thank you for checking out the series here. And I'm going to be pushing myself. I haven't done this in a while. Oh yeah, I got this taken care of. We talked and we sorted it out. Originally, this space was claimed by another guy, but he had like a sign 80 blocks that way, and I didn't see it when I started to get building my gear, because he had it like on the underwater, and then there was like a little sign. I think it might still be there, but it's like out of my render distance, so I didn't realize. But he was nice and saw that I had already started, so he let me continue. Anyways, what was I talking about? Yeah, okay, so this series, I'm going to try to push myself and be really consistent. So I haven't, in like my whole lifetime of my YouTubing career, I haven't ever really been like, I haven't ever really been like consistent with a series. So I really want to push myself to be consistent and upload like one video a week, and if I'm doing that smoothly, I might even try to do two of these a week at the same time each week. So today is the 14th, and I'm real anxious to get this episode out there, so I might make it every Wednesday. So that would be the day after I'm recording this. So I might try to upload these episodes every Wednesday, and yeah, I just need to, if I want to take YouTube seriously, I need to start being more consistent with it and, you know, really be scheduled. So that's what I'm going to do, because I'd like to take YouTubing more seriously. But yeah, that's going to wrap it up for this episode. Thank you everybody so much for checking it out. I hope you liked the gear base. And I'll see you guys again in the next one. Bye-bye. Take care.